Just wanted to show you how to quickly create a weather map real quick through everything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up a new project right here. This is a short version. If you're a little bit confused or need extra help, go ahead and check out the longer version of this. So I'm just going to go ahead and click home. I'm going to choose layout. I'm going to choose blank layout. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going ahead and I'm going to insert my background picture. So you're going to go ahead and search whatever country you're going to do. I'm going to go ahead and click South America. I'm going to go ahead and click this. I don't want to drag it like this because it's going to distort the figure. So I always want to go ahead and drag any shape that I have through the corner. So now I went ahead and had my map. Now I'm going to go ahead and put in some different objects. So I'm going to find a sun that I like. I'm going to go ahead and enter that here. I'm going to go ahead and put that in. If you type in cloud, so maybe it's partly cloudy or partly sunny, however you want to look at that. And then if I type in cloud here, they actually have a lot of great options. So, hay chubascos, hay un arco iris. So I'm going to do this, do a variety of vocabulary, going through the different amounts of whatever I would like. So the next thing I'm going to need to do is I'm going to go ahead and need to label some of these cities. So I'm going to go ahead and click insert, click on text box. I'm going to go ahead. Once I've clicked on it, I'm going to drag my mouse and drop. That's going to give me an area. I'm going to want this to be nice and bold. Choose a nice font that's easy to read. Maybe make that a little bit bigger. Type in the name of the city. So for example, we're going to do Argentina, Buenos Aires. And I'm going to go ahead and move that over here. So this is a little bit harder to see, so you might want to move it around here. Or I could do something where I insert a dot, insert a shape. And now what I can do is I can change this if I double click. So now I could do something like this where I go Buenos Aires. And then I can move this over here so it's easier to see the city. So that's basically how to make a map. If I want to make it look a little bit more professional, I'm going to go ahead and right click on the mouse, click format background. I'm going to go ahead and click gradient fill, and then I can go ahead and pick any color that I want. I'm going to choose blue. Done. Okay, so that's how simple it is. Now if I want to create a different forecast. So for example, I'm going to do the 6-day forecast. I'm just going to do insert table. I'm going to do 6-day forecast or 5-day forecast, whatever I want. I don't like those colors, so I'm going to make mine purple. Make this a little bit bigger. I can change anything I want through here. So what I'm going to go ahead and do here is I'm going to make this one a little bit bigger. I'm going to go ahead and insert my clip art. Just like I've done before. I'm going to drag the corner here. Okay, so I would go ahead, click through all of this, and eventually what I would do, sorry about that, is I would go ahead, find a nice font, make sure it's bold. I stuck with the purple thing. Go ahead and write out the days of the week, here's my weather, and then my weather forecaster can talk about it. The last thing to make this degrees Celsius thing, what you're going to do is you are going to make a capital C, and then before it, you're going to do a lowercase o. You're going to highlight that, drag click right here, you're going to go to superscript, that's how you get that through there. Now the last thing that we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and save our map. Or perhaps what you want to do is you want to do one for an extended forecast. So morning, afternoon, night, you could do something like that where you could put some information here. So if I'm happy with this, I can save this as a PowerPoint, but that's not going to get me the weather map image that I need. So I actually have to save this if I'm not making any more changes as a JPEG or a PNG file. So I'm going to go ahead and click Save As. I'm going to save this as Super Awesome Map. And instead of a PowerPoint presentation, which I'll still be able to change, once you make this a image file, you can't change it anymore. So you have to make sure that there's no typos or anything else on it. I can save it as a GIF, a JPEG, a PNG. Any of those work? I'm going to save this as a JPEG. Now, because I have a couple different slides, it's going to ask me if I want to export every slide. So it's going to do each one of these as a separate image, and that's what I want, so I can import those into the video that I'm going to be making later. So every slide, or you could just do the one. And then what you're going to be able to do is wherever you saved it, you're going to be able to pull that up. And now if you look, I have my different JPEG images. Best of luck with your projects.